I've installed Arch Linux a few times now, but when I heard they added an official guided installer, I was really interested in trying it out. So while we still have the test hard drive in this computer, let's try doing a dual boot between Windows and Arch Linux. First, let's partition the disk using gparted because my life is too short to do it with the command line utility. And so there we have it. This partition has Windows. This is an empty ext4 formatted partition, which we're going to install Arch Linux on. And this small partition at the end is the Windows recovery partition. We can take note of that dev sda3, but we'll see that it's the only partition formatted with ext4. So now let's reboot and start up the Arch Linux installer. As you can see, it's the one from April 1st, 2021, which is the latest one as of right now. And on their website, it says here, the image can be burned to a CD. No, it can't. It's too big to fit on a CD. 750 megabytes. So you can only fit it in a DVD or USB drive. But never mind, here it is. Let's start it up. Okay, first let's try connecting to Wi-Fi. Of course, I've read the Arch Wiki, and I know you can connect with a command. And now we can start this new guided install program, which is called archinstall. Okay, select one of the above keyboard languages. I use the US keyboard, actually US International, but regular US is good enough for now. Select one of the above regions to download packages from. I'll do my country. Select one of the above disks. So the hard drive is dev SDA, so 2. We want to keep the existing partition layout, and there is only one ext4 partition, which is the one we want to install Arch on, so 1. The mount point is slash. File system ext4, that's fine. And that's it. We don't want to set up any other partitions. We don't want this encryption right now. Desired host name, root password. It recommends to leave it blank, so I'll do that. Super user with pseudo privileges, so that's going to be the regular user account. We don't want to create a additional user. Pre-programmed profiles. What should we do? Awesome, desktop, GNOME, KDE, KDE Wayland, and Xorg. Well, out of all of those, I'm more familiar with GNOME, so I'll choose that. Graphic card drivers, this one only has Intel, so 2. Additional packages to install. I guess it's gonna install the basic packages for me. If the system works, I'll install additional packages later. Network configuration. I think I can just copy the ISO network configuration, but I'm not sure. Let's see what happens if we try to configure it again. The HCP, valid time zone, and there we have it. This is a JSON file. First thing we can see is that in the hard drive section, it has dev SDA, but it doesn't have my partition that I specified, dev SDA 3. I'm willing to take the risk because this is not an important installation. If it wipes the entire hard drive, I won't mind in this case. Everything else looks correct, so let's press enter to continue. And as you can see, it's doing a countdown to format the entire drive. Maybe. We'll see. Now it's formatting dev SDA 3, so that's good. But the countdown that just says dev SDA, which is the whole drive, is a bit scary. And it failed. Mounting partition. Yeah, what's the problem with that? Why did it fail? Should we try again? Whoops, I pressed enter instead of setting the host name. So what do I do now? I can't go back. I have to quit the script and start all over again. Control C. And this time it crashed more quickly. The program to format the partition did not exit gracefully, because it's mounted, will not make a file system here. So I guess we have to unmount it. So I decided to try again off camera. This time I used gpart to create a small boot partition, which you shouldn't need on a system without EFI. But I did it anyway. That partition formatted as FAT32 and then the rest with ext4, and now it seems to be installing. I also chose to copy the network configuration from the ISO, so maybe I don't have to type my Wi-Fi password again after installation if it succeeds. And now this may take a while because it's gonna have to download a lot of packages, and it's installing them on a slow hard drive. It's clear that they didn't test this script very much. It seems to be designed for EFI systems only, because here we have a very clear error. File system is not on a GPT partition table, which is true. Right now I don't have any EFI systems to try Arch on, or do I? Well, actually I do. Here is the HP Stream 13. I installed Chrome OS on it using Cloud Ready, and I decided to keep it because it works so well. But now I'm gonna try installing Arch Linux on it just to see if the Arch install script works. And I can always reinstall Cloud Ready if I want. You can't actually reboot Chrome OS, you have to shut down. And then you turn it back on manually. Secure boot is off, of course. I connected to Wi-Fi, it worked, so let's install. In this computer, the main drive is not SDA, but it's MMCBLK0. Chrome OS makes several partitions, but we can format the entire drive in this case. We'll use ext4 for the main partition. And I know GNOME uses a lot of system resources, but we'll choose it anyway. This one also only has Intel graphics. And we'll copy the network configuration. Okay, now it's installing packages. Thankfully, it includes Nano. So just in case we need a command line text editor. Because if you install Arch the normal way, it doesn't even include that. Look at that! Installation was actually successful. I restarted, removed the USB flash drive, and there it is, it's booted up. So let's log in. And there's Arch Linux with the GNOME desktop environment, which looks a bit different from the last time I tried GNOME. The dock used to be on the left, now it's at the bottom, and the desktop background is smaller. Oh, you can click on it and it goes to the desktop. Oh, and this is like the thing to switch desktops, okay. It used to be a menu on the right. It still doesn't have minimize and maximize buttons turned on by default, which is quite annoying. You can easily fix that with the GNOME Tweaks application, but it's a bit annoying that it doesn't have those buttons by default. But this installation is only a test, so I won't complain too much. So here we have the About window. Oh, it has reverse trackpad scrolling, I hate that. Let's change it. Natural scrolling. If this is natural, I'd rather have the unnatural option. Okay, now it's scrolling up and down correctly. It has the Wayland windowing system instead of Xorg. Even though I saw Xorg being installed, so that's odd, but whatever works. And network isn't working because network manager is not running. I think it's not installed. Can we open a terminal to check? Yes, in Linux you have to use the terminal quite often. Oh no, it is installed. We just have to run it. And there we go. But it didn't copy the configuration, so I have to type the password again. Uh-oh, connection failed. Maybe I typed the password incorrectly. Anyway, I think we can enable the network manager service so network manager starts up automatically. There you go. You have to use proper capitalization. I'm not really sure what's wrong, but this video is not about troubleshooting Arch Linux, so if you have a specific setup, the archinstall script works. That's what we learned today. So that's it. Thank you for watching.